This presentation shows you how to analyse a design with Tolcap, how to do it, when and why. The simplified example sets out to show how to analyse the components of a design using Tolcap and how to calculate a stack tolerance. But it also shows when to use Tolcap, which will turn out to be as early in the design stage as possible, and how Tolcap raises questions about the design, questions you need to address with your supplier to ensure you have a sound design. Here's the example. It's a camera of some sort and it has three components: a heatsink, a body, and a lens. The table also shows the dimensions and first cut tolerances in the stack that defines the image distance in the camera. The heatsink dimension, 3 mm plus or minus 0.05, is the height of a raised platform for a photodiode array that's connected to a surrounding printed circuit board. The body, which is 12 mm long plus or minus 0.01, just spaces the lens from the photodiode array. The lens is injection molded PMMA. The front part of the lens from the mounting shoulder is 7 mm plus or minus 0.1. Accepting the assigned tolerances, the distance from the front of the lens to the image on the heatsink is 22 plus or minus 0.16, worst case. We may root sum square the tolerances and say the stack dimension is 22 plus or minus 0.11225, okay, 22 plus or minus 0.11. But is root sum squaring valid and meaningful? Anyway, other component tolerance is achievable. Let's use Tolcap to estimate CPK for the assigned tolerances. Open Tolcap and log in. To analyse the heatsink, select casting and pressure die casting for copper alloys. Enter the dimension 3 and the tolerance plus or minus 0.05 and click calculate. There is no MP wizard shown because the map is specific to the material. There's no modification from the GP or VP wizard. Even so, CPK is estimated at 0.69, an unacceptably low answer. To find the capable tolerance, click on the CPK tab, change the target CPK to 1.33, and click calculate. The tolerance needed to achieve CPK equals 1.33 is plus or minus 0.082. Next, analyse the body. To analyse the body, select machining and turning and boring. Click the tolerance tab. Enter the dimension 12 and tolerance 0.01 and click calculate. The predicted CPK is 1.64, but next we click the MP wizard and the drop-down arrow and select copper, then click update chart. The predicted CPK falls to 1.4, and next click the GP wizard. The body starts as a casting to save material, so it has to be turned round at some point in the machining process. So specify one additional setup operation and click update chart. The predicted CPK is 1.29, which is close enough to 1.33 to be considered an acceptable design. For the camera lens, select plastic injection molding and injection compression PETP PF PMMA. the material we're using. Click the Tolerance tab, enter the dimension 7 and tolerance 0.1, click Calculate, CPK is 2.34 so far. Next, click the GP wizard. The characteristic is across the parting line, which it wasn't on the heatsink, and click Update chart. The predicted CPK falls to 1.22. Next, click the VP wizard. Does the need for optical properties impose any limitations on material flow, etc.? I don't know. Let's admit ignorance here and select yes in answer to the last question and click Update chart. The predicted CPK is 0.66. To find a tolerance that gives an acceptable CPK, select the CPK tab and set target CPK to 1.33, click Calculate, and find the tolerance should be plus or minus 0.160. So now we have CPK equals 1.33 capable tolerances. The heatsink 0.082, the body plus or minus 0.01, and the lens 0.160. Now with capable tolerances, the distance from the front lens to the image on the heatsink is 22 plus or minus 0.252 exactly. The root sum square of the tolerances is 0.180. Using the formula we derived for CPK equals 1.3 tolerances, which is T stack is 3/11 of the sum of the tolerances plus 8/11 of the root sum square of the tolerances, we get T stack coming to 0.2. This design is presented to illustrate how to use Tolcap and how to calculate a stack tolerance. That said, it also serves to highlight when to use Tolcap and how it can improve the design process. The example is presented as a diagram. This is just to show that Tolcap is best used early in the design process before a drawing commits you to some concept. Don't just look at the CPK values or tolerances that you get from Tolcap. Look at the processes you selected and the answers you gave in the wizards. These can steer your design and your project. Take the lens, for example. We wondered whether the requirement for optical properties affects process capability. We didn't know, so we assumed it did. We need to find the real answer to the question, so we should ask the supplier. Don't ask whether they think it does or doesn't. Ask for an explanation and vitally for evidence that it does not. Have they made similar lenses before? Don't they have process capability data on them we can use for comparison? If the optical requirement doesn't in fact affect process capability, we can go back to the analysis and reduce the tolerance. Is dimensioning to the front of the lens avoidable? Is it even appropriate? If it's necessary, consider mounting the lens inside the body onto the front face so that the dimension is on one side of the die. But look at the optical equations. The thickness of the lens will have an effect on its focal length, but maybe the shape should be adjusted so the lens is convex on both faces. Maybe the optical centre could be brought in line with the mounting feature. Maybe rather than include the lens in the stack, it's better to review optics and their sensitivity to dimensional variation. On the heatsink, the design assumes a raw casting will be satisfactory. It may be necessary to machine the casting to clean up the faces or to achieve tighter tolerances if it's necessary to improve the stack tolerance. On the body, the capable tolerance is an order of magnitude smaller than for the other components in the stack. This may be an opportunity for cost reduction. Do we need to machine the casting? Is there an alternative process to produce the part? We hope this example has demonstrated how to analyse a design using Tolcap and how to calculate a stack tolerance. Also, when to use Tolcap as early in the design stage as you possibly can, how Tolcap raises questions about the design, questions you need to address with your supplier to ensure you have a sound design, and questions to pose about your design and tasks to incorporate into the design project. Thank you again for listening. For more information, visit www.tolcap.com.